think I'm going back into this nose cone. I've got a bit more in shape in there. I decided to cut out the really bad bits, and I've been pressing this again in the press and trying to get some kind of shape. And then this bit was garbage as well, so I'll make a new bit for there. And a bit for there, might just cut it out down here and just take that whole square. Got the new welder, so hopefully it's not too bad. I have been cutting out some of the bits I did earlier because I wasn't happy with them. And I've formed up this bit here. And I'm going to put it underneath. So when I weld, there's a bit of 2mm underneath the old stuff. So the plan is to just tack it all the way around. I've got the new CO2 welder. Yeah, I think I'm going to use it. It does tick, but I need to learn that first. I bent this up on the jig, the press that you're sitting on. And there's a hole over here as well to sort. It was beyond sorting, so I just cut it out. Do the same there, probably stick something. Well, I won't have to do it there because there's a double thickness there, but I'm going to probably stick something underneath it to, and then we can use filler to blend it. And this dips, I've made it up as well. Yeah, this is my profile piece. So what I can do is, because that's in an arch, it'll come onto here and get welded. And then we can cut it after it's welded, really. That's your profile for here. Slightly too big. And bits we can sort. That is my plan. Whether it'll work or not, I don't know. See how the new CO2 does. Right, we'll go and set up the CO2 and I'll bring you back once I'm all ready to start welding. I may have done a video on this welder before you see this, but it's MIG, MAG, gasless and stick, all in one welder, and TIG. So on the voltage, this wire feed here, we change the amps, it changes the wire feed for it automatically, so it matches it. So we'll see how it goes. I only just quite worked out what voltages to use yet, like, but it's gonna put you behind this welding glass. You couldn't do that with my old MIG welder, it would be stop, start, stop, start. Thank you. cool off. I'll stick it in the sawdust over there. That's it. Faster. Well, we're running 52 amps. Oh, this one's right in the right place. The right place here. I think the lead ought to be pushed well, and I think good. Just a little well. Let's see if it can be pushed well. I can actually see if it can be better then. what? Yeah, that is better because I can see what I'm doing now. I'll rephrase that. I can only see what I'm doing. Put the corner and we should be good. Wanted an extra bit here so I had something to work with here above. Bit to buff down, but it's not too bad. I'm going to cool off a bit. Get the other part ready. I'll bring you back once I'm all ready for the next bit. I've got this bit clipped up now and I'm going to weld it here and here. And then I'm trying to decide whether I'm going on top or in the bottom. Probably going on top because we've got to cut it anyway, so we'll give it that stronger structure at the ground. We'll do the wash this bit. Go on the back here and that'll be the last time. Good idea. Well, that's that done. It's not the best weld in the world as usual, but I'll cut it along there and then I can grind it in it. Hopefully there's enough penetration to let us round it off a bit. If not, we can run a weld. But what a difference it's made putting a bit of 2mm under it. You're not fighting with this thin tin anymore. You know, there's something solid in there. Plus that new welder's really good. So I've got that bit there to do and that bit there to do. Might have to go out this afternoon to the airport, so I'm just going to cut that out, I think, and come in here, because this is 2mm here, so we've got a bend in it. Get rid of this rubbish. Not so worried about this, because, like I say, I'm going to use filler to blend everything, as long as the metal's in roughly the right place, which that isn't. It'll be okay. Oh, it's a learning experience. Why did you start this in the first place? Oh, and I've still missed it well then. then maybe sort the sides out. I'm not sure if I'm just going to leave them as they are, and then just, I think I'll just leave them and bolt them. One side needs re-welded anyway, so. Can't remember. Looks like that's too high anyway, so. Gets outside, and then there's a bit to go on the inside. I think if I'd had this new welder, I'd have got on a lot better. If I hadn't blown up the gasless, mind you, the gasless was too hot, that was a big problem with it. That's okay, I can fill that. Probably, I've noticed all the custom guys in America put a coat of filler across the whole thing and then sand the filler down. I'll try and avoid that if I can, but I've got the patches welded in today with a new welder. It's been really quick compared to the old one. The black line you see there on the right is actual more or less profile of this side, so I've got to fill in. What a grinding to do, and get some welding at the sides here. There's a longer version of this on IGTV apparently.